Welcome back to the fourth day of build guides with me and Exotic Llama. Today's build is going to be an Elemental Blade Vortex Berserker. Berserker, for a number of reasons. Specifically, though, the leech is just insane from Berserker. 1% damage leeched as life, 1% damage leeched as mana. This takes the place of Warlord's Mark for pretty much every other Blade Vortex build out there. Seeing as they all need life and mana leech, this is just a fantastic node. And it allows you to run maps with, like, hexproof on them. It allows you to really take on hexproof mobs in the first place. Then you move down, you get these for more damage, and then some extra leech for leech tanking. And then, it's a berserker, so it is starting down here. Get some life, life. Over here, life. Then you're going to want this skill effect duration, which is really important on Blade Vortex. Because Blade Vortex is something you cast, it has a duration built in. I think it's like 9 seconds or something like that. But getting like 40% skill duration right there is pretty important. And later on, for quality of life, you could even come and pick up these. Though I think I opt to take increased duration as a socket and grab more damage on the tree. Then I come over here for some life, life, and area of effect, because it is an area of effect skill, and getting these AoE nodes and these AoE nodes do make a difference. It's not as noticeable anymore since the radius and stuff was changed a while back, but it is still nice to have. It is a crit build, so you're using the spell crit nodes here. You get some life. Power charge for more spell crit. Come along down for Throat Seeker and crit multi. And you're going to get some crit down here. You're going to get some fizz damage and crit. Then you've got Vol Pact, life, and fizz damage. These are especially good nodes with Blade Vortex. And then you get some phase acro, and Heart Seeker. And that's the build at level 90. It's a lot of traveling. It's kind of awkward to level with, but you have to level with something like Sunder. You can't just take Blade Vortex right out of the gate. Trust me, I'm pretty sure I've tried that, and it just doesn't feel good. So you can use something like Sunder, respec like 10 points later on to drop the melee damage nodes and build into this. So what does this give you? Well, it gives you 546k DPS while on 20 blades. It's something you can map with, having 20 blades. Most people wouldn't. They'll normally do like 10 blades. So if you drop down to that, it is 207,000. So it's still perfectly good for mapping. It's basically the same DPS that something like RF would give you. And RF just walks through maps. So there you go. And you've also got 6k life. Then you've got your Vol Pact and phase acro for defenses, which is nice. So let's look at the skill gems. I've got a Blasphemy Assassin's Mark set up over here with Hatred. Enlighten is not necessary. It just gives you some more room with your reserved mana. You got a Lightning Golem. You get Blood Rage for Frenzy Charge Generation. And then over to Blade Vortex. And none of these gems are even 20 quality with these numbers. So if I up them to 20 and lower some of their levels, you can see that it's actually 581k DPS, which is still respectable. I think it's actually an increase. So you're using Blade Vortex with increased critical strikes. That's because it's a crit build and it kind of needs it. Then increased AoE, that can be traded for Conk Effect for single target. And that will take you up to 878k DPS. Much nicer. Then you've got Spell Echo, because it helps you build your stacks much faster. Fizz to Lightning, because it is an elemental build, and you're going to be converting everything from Fizz over to an element. And then increased duration for quality of life. If you're fighting bosses, though, you can ultimately swap your increased AoE and increased duration for Conk and added Fire. And that will take you up to 1,070,000 DPS. Which is pretty insane, considering this isn't even the top-end version of the build. You could have much better gear. You could have a dual curse set up instead of the hatred, and it makes things a lot better. But that is the normal setup you would run around with, and then you just have the conch effect and added fire either in your inventory or in a socket somewhere, and then you just swap them out real quick, and there you go. Onto the items. Got a Doriani's Catalyst, a Wrath Pith right here, and what these items do is they give you a lot of damage. This gives you a lot of LE damage, while this gives you a lot of spell damage. It also gives you some block, which is handy, but you're taking acrobatics, so it doesn't matter so much. The more important part is the increased maximum life. Later on, you'd want to replace both of these with rare items. This one being a like spell damage, added damage to spells, crit multi-attack speed scepter. You get those six mods, and it makes the damage go up quite a bit more. You end up with like, I don't know, the same amount of damage that Wrath Pith gives you added on top, and then some. And it allows you to change some things around in the build. Over here, I think, it at least makes things more comfortable with getting towards crit cap. And then you've got a Belly of the Beast for life, a just plain evasion helmet. You can switch that for a Star Conjures or something if you want, though I didn't opt to do that. Then you've got a Hrimburn. This converts 50% of your fizz over to cold damage. You can also use Hrim Sorrow, the non-faded version of these gloves, and it works just the same. They'll just be a little bit cheaper. Then you've got your just plain evasion boots, you know, resists, move speed, life, whatever. Biscos, this has one curse on it because I was playing with a dual curse setup, and I can show you that in just a moment, but you're going to use Biscos just to get extra map drops and extra currency as well. Plain opal rings with life, and then, you know, a super life belt. There are three jewels socketed on the tree, and they all have fizz damage, life, and crit multi. Just three mod jewels, so nothing too crazy there. For your flasks, you've got a Basalt Flask, Diamond to help you get towards crit cap, Quicksilver of Adrenaline, an Alchemist Quicksilver of Adrenaline specifically. Then you've got Atziri's Promise, which sort of double dips whenever it comes to fizz conversion builds, which is really nice. It adds the fizz damage first as extra chaos, and then the LE damage is also taken advantage of, whereas most builds will only take one or the other mod. Both of these are put into use as extra chaos, which is really nice. And then you've got a Taste of Hate, which is basically Basalt Flask number 2, so you get a lot of fizz mitigation in this build, and it also gives you the 25% fizz as extra cold, which is quite nice. So if I'm going to play around with the dual curse setup by getting an enemy can have an additional curse Biscos, which might be a little expensive, basically you just take off Hatred, you put on Elemental Weakness, and your damage goes from, what is that, 581k to 642k. Then if you get an Enlighten, you can also use Herald of Ash, and it'll take you over 700k in the normal mapping setup. Then if you want to look at single target with that, swap off these two gems, and then go to that, and it's 1.3 million single target. So this is something that could be pretty good as an Uber Lab farmer, especially if you added things like Endurance Charges in for, or, I mean, you could run it as a Juggernaut or something and use Warlord's Mark at that point, and you would just get a lot more fizz mitigation, and you could just straight up face tank Izaro. Otherwise, I would be sure to take a lot more life on the tree. There's a node here, there are two nodes here, there's some nodes right here which are valuable. Yeah, that's pretty much it, but I would be sure to take more life on the tree if you are going to try to do Uber Lab, because 6k is kind of low, especially if he gets any damage mods. So this is my second to last day of uploading build guides. There'll be another one coming up tomorrow with, I think, the build I'm actually going to be playing in the launch of 3.0. It's going to come up just before I start streaming. And, yeah. See you guys there. Thanks for watching.